CTV or catch up on CTV.ca in the CTV app. Journalists are free to report on court proceedings, but only with limitations imposed in specific cases and with the more general restriction that they not use cameras and recording devices. But it's time to reconsider that. The public's right to witness court proceedings in person, which was established centuries ago, should be expanded to include the right to watch remotely. Today's discrete technology renders invalid the old argument that large cameras and bright lights would distract from the proceedings. That's not to suggest that there be cameras in every courtroom for every case. There will always be legitimate reasons not to televise cases, including a lack of public interest. But in the most important and high-profile cases, cameras should be permitted to. In the United States, which is much more liberal about this than we are, and we do allow courts to have cameras in some cases, Donald Trump is being tried without cameras, and already his supporters are questioning whether he's getting a fair trial. So the tax cut now realize that in today's skeptical world, in order for justice to be seen to be done, it must first be seen. I'm Steve Murphy.
And Steve will return. We turn our attention to medical headlines now. There are events in the Maritimes raising money and awareness for ovarian cancer research, plus the benefits from a break from social media. CTV's Amanda Dempsey has more on all that in tonight's edition of The Lifeline.
An ovarian cancer survivor is opening up about her experience in advance of the event that aims to raise money and awareness for the disease. I had scans done, and it showed a 16-centimeter mass in my pelvis.
Jennifer Gutierrez was diagnosed with ovarian cancer in March of 2022. Speaking on CTV Morning Live, she wants women to listen to their bodies and share concerning symptoms with their healthcare provider.
I had symptoms, but as a postmenopausal woman, I just brushed it off as that.
Gutierrez will be participating in the Lady Ball, a supportive night out that raises money and awareness for ovarian cancer research. More than $139,000 was raised last year. The Charlottetown Lady Ball on May 30th is sold out, but tickets are still available for the Halifax event on Thursday, May 9th. According to the Canadian Cancer Society, an estimated 3,100 Canadian women were diagnosed with ovarian cancer last year. Women in perimenopause may be more likely to experience depression. The study quantified the risk of depression during the transition to menopause, known as perimenopause, showing that women in this stage are about 40% more likely to experience the mental health condition than premenopausal women. Authors of the study say there needs to be more awareness about the shifts in mental health so women can receive appropriate help. Perimenopause typically happens about 3 to 5 years before menopause. Finally, a new Canadian study has found young women who take